Start. Good afternoon, everyone. This is our project on underground cable fault detection of copper wire using Arduino and GSM. So, under the guidance of Pragati KNMM, I am Utkarsh Pantavne. Okay, I am Utkarsh Pantavne, and my projectees are Mrunal Nistani and Rushabh Niswade.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Mrunal Mohisha Nistane. In the introduction, the currently wire is laid underground to protect them to any adverse conditions such as heavy rainfall, storm and snow, and also by a pollution. Due to this safety reason, the high power requirement in densely populated area, use of the underground cable has been sharp hike in the recent time. It is difficult to trace the exact location, and it is difficult to find the exact fault location. This is time to consuming. This is time consuming and inefficient. Not only the manpower resources is utilized, but also the restoration time may vary depending on the reliability of the cable. Then the authority, the unaware of the fault location and occurrence, hence it is necessary to give the proper information about the fault of. But does not convey the message to authority. The second is identification of the underground cable fault location and development, and it is a published in 2017, but it is circuit has a complicated. Third, it is a underground cable fault distance convey over GSM. It is published in 2016. Then the finding is fault in optical is fiber is detected. Then the design and implementation of wire live wire fault detector and protection in remote area. It is in this paper the project detect. Next, again methodology.
Okay. Yes, sir. Sir, this is the block diagram of our project in which we use switches to create a fault, Arduino Uno to detect the fault, GSM module to send message to maintenance authority, power supply to give to Arduino Uno and GSM module, and LCD display to display the fault in kilometers. So as we press the switch, and in our model we use two wires, wire 1 and wire 2. In wire 1 we have at 2 kilometer we place a switch for creating fault, and at 4 kilometer similar to the wire 2. If we press switch at 2 kilometer, then the Arduino you know detect that the fault it at 2 kilometer, then LCD it send message to LCD display that display fault at 2 kilometer, and and similar to GSM module that send message to maintenance of the authority that the fault is occur at 2 kilometer. Next. So this is the flowchart of our project in which initialization of all input and output pins of Arduino, LCD and GSM. This is the condition. If switch is pressed, then display the location of fault in LCD and send using GSM. Otherwise it directly send a message that there is no fault, the wire 1 and wire 2 are okay.
Here we are simply using the concept of Ohm's law. So here by pressing the switch, we are applying voltage, and the change in current will in the change in cable the change in current varies, and depending upon the length of the fall, it will determine where the fault is happening. Next. So previously they have used microcontroller or with GSM or Arduino with buzzer only to indicate fault. Here we are using Arduino as well as GSM such that it will show the fault in the LCD display which is connected to Arduino, and GSM module will send SMS to the maintenance authority via SMS.
This is the circuit diagram of our project, in which there is an Arduino LCD display, GSM module, and a pot and other switches. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Salve. Good afternoon, everyone. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. The topic of our project is speaking system for dumb people using hand gesture under the guidance of Shubhangini Ungle ma'am. The name of my project is Sanket Khobragade, Sahil Rangari, Shankar Kosre, and my name is Ankush Chute. Methodology.
So our problem statements slide presents the problem that around 2.78% people in our country are not able to speak. Either they are born dumb or because of some vocal problem they stop speaking. So we have and the next point is that it is very difficult for dumb people to communicate with the normal people. And what we are trying to do is reduce the communication gap between the vocally disadvantaged people and the normal people. So the method. The methodology that we have proposed is that first we will need to use the hand signs which are used by the dumb people, and using that signs we will need to convert those signs into text and speech output so that the dumb people are easily able to communicate with the normal people. And to display the text output we are going to need an LCD display, and for voice output we are going to use a loudspeaker. We have used a loudspeaker. This is the block diagram of our project. The input part is the flex sensor. We have used 5 flex sensors here, and that is the power supply section. The Atmega 16 is the microcontroller that we have used in our project, and through which the output will be displayed on the LCD display. And another portion is the text to speech circuit through which we will be getting the voice output on the loudspeaker. the flowchart here. First, the input part is the hand signs that will be given from flex sensor to the microcontroller. And if the hand sign which we are using is recognized by the microcontroller, then the output will be displayed on the LCD display and then on the loudspeaker. If the hand sign is not recognized, then we will have to again implement that sign on the glove. Next slide. Implementation. The flex sensors we are using, we have mounted on the glove. 5 flex sensors, 1 for each finger. The flex sensors are going to provide the input signal to the microcontroller. That is the gestures, the actual gestures that are used by dumb people. And the Atmega 16 microcontroller will be providing us with the appropriate text output that we have installed in our programming. And the speech output will be getting from the loudspeaker via the text-to-speech circuit. Next slide.
Hello. वो रख दे बाद में ले लेना वो पोस्टर वहाँ पे देना है So
A very warm regarding to one and all present over here. Our project topic is voice-based wireless notice board by using GSM module. Our project guide name is Dr. Vivek Kapoor sir and co-guide name is Professor Suraj Gohane sir. And my project is I Diksha Goreswar, Ankita Katare, Bobby Sudame and Tanushree Gojre. Next.
Hello, my name is Bobby Sudame. The problem is before this device was designed by using Bluetooth and the Bluetooth has range 10 to 20 meters. As the user crosses that 20 meters, the device will be disconnected. And to connect it, we have to do all the procedure and all the coding configuration to connect it again. So we are using GSM so that we can use it from any corner of the world. And we don't have to connect it again and again. As we register our number, we don't have to connect it again. That's why we are using GSM over Bluetooth. Next.
The proposed methodology is by GSM module, the signal is given to the microcontroller, which is known as Arduino, and then it given to the CPU, which is LED matrix, which we are using to display our message, and then it given to the shift register, which is also connected to the display, which shift the character as the string. Next.
I am Tanushree Gojre. This is the hardware of our project. The main four. Okay, sir.
Sir, welcome. Actually, the message is hello, welcome, but. It is just a sample to show you that.
Our next slide is circuit diagram where we are using four main hardware, which is adapter, GSM, Arduino and LED display. Where the 12-volt adapter is connected to the GSM, which is ground and VCC, and then GSM and Arduino ground is connected. Then the TX pin where the transmitter of the Arduino is connected to the receiving part of the GSM and the receiving part of the Arduino is connected to the GSM where the transmitter pin is. Then the LED matrix 5-volt display, 5-volt supply is connected to the Arduino and the RX pin of the LED display is connected to the Arduino where we have using 11 pin number 11 as a software pin. And the ground of the LED display is connected to the Arduino, which is ground as the Arduino.
This is the flowchart. As we start, the GSM will initialize. If the GSM will not be initialized, it will again go back and it will start the GSM. If GSM will start, then it's check the message. If the message is not present over there, then it will again went back to check the message. If the message is given, then it will check if it is sent by the authorized person or not. If it is not sent by the authorized person, it will again check for the message. And then it will check if it is sent by the authorized person or not. If it is sent by the authorized person, then it will went to the display notice board LED matrix. If the previous message is already present, it will replace the previous message and the new message will be displayed. Till the next message, it will continuously displayed in a loop path. Next.
I'm Bobby Sudhaman. Innovative work in our project is it sent notice wirelessly by using GSM. And this device can be controlled from, as I said, any place. And we are interfacing this with LED. We will interface it with LEDs, LCD screen instead of LED. And also the voice is the new innovation in this project. Tanu, naam batana.
What?
Nahi laga.
I'm Tanushree Khojre. This is the work done of our project, where the slide which is there is the software of our project, where we have done programming. When we are done programming, compiling and uploading, then we are sending the message, which is this slide. And we whenever the slide is message is sending the next slide. Whenever we are sending the message will be displayed on the LED matrix, which is this slide. Blur result.
Myself, Ankita Katare. The result is to display the output or the information on the display board. The display board. The display board is the one of the most communication medium for to send a message or the information on the display board. The local languages can be used on the display board. This is the variation in the in this project. The graphical and the decoding techniques. Other decoding techniques can be used to display the messages.
Hello, I'm Bobby Sudhame. And in this way, we have worked on our project. And we have designed our project. And the advantages of this project are it saves our time, also our energy, and it does not use paper as traditionally before this all the notices were displayed on the paper. So this project is very useful in that way. And the device, in future scope, the device can also be developed by using IoT. And the output of the project is, in future, the output of the project will be displayed on the LCD screen or a TV screen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, because we are using GSM, and before this, the device were developed by using Bluetooth, so it is innovative.
Sir, also we are including a voice now, so it is innovative. Voice based it is. Yes, sir. By using that.
Actually, we are we will use the app on that as we speak. It will type and it will send.
जैसे आउट ऑफ कंट्री जाओगे आपका नंबर भी चेंज हो जाएगा तो सर इधर तो उधर तो इंडिया का सिम अच्छा इंटरनेशनल सिम होगा तो यस सर जैसे हमें दूसरा जैसे आप इस नंबर भी चेंज करते हो और आपका नंबर इंटरनेशनल भी है तो हमने वो नंबर रजिस्टर कर दिया है और आप जैसे मैसेज सेंड करोगे वैसे आपको भी पता चल जाएगा कि टेक्स्ट मैसेज सेंड हुआ है
सर आपके पास भी एक स्मॉल सर्किट रहेगा जिसमें एलसीडी डिस्प्ले कनेक्ट रहेगा तो वहाँ से आप देख सकते हो कि मैसेज सर That portion we have not covered it. Actually,
number of this.
So actually, we will register the number which is authenticated number, and only that. So then we can change it now.
A very good afternoon to one and all present here. Before starting, I would like to introduce you with my project project mates, that is Silent. The topic of our project is solar-based portable physiotherapy machine. Problem statement. As we know today, patients are not able to go some patients are unable to walk some patients are unable to walk as having problem to for as going out for physiotherapy sessions this machine will overcome the that problem of people who cannot move anywhere from their home and rural area peoples, they can't afford the fees of the physiotherapy sessions. So this machine will overcome that problem also, as it is lighter in weight and cheaper. So we can take it where we want to take, or where the people need that treatment. And as a physiotherapy session treatment needs 200 rupees per day for a one session is of 200 rupees. And this is not. Not everyone can afford this thing. So this machine will overcome that problem. And when we go to physiotherapy sessions, there are many more patients over there. And for physiotherapy sessions, physiotherapists give exactly more 2 or 3 hours to the patients. And at that period of time, it is not possible to attend each and every patient, and not every individual person not get that full attention of physiotherapy doctors. And this machine will overcome that problem also. Limited physiotherapists are there, as we know. Limited physiotherapists are there, and when a person or a patient who wants treatment can easily, if no one is with him, he can treat himself by his own. This machine is handled by both patients as well as the relative. Slides aage piche ho gayi hai na. Sir, it's shuffled actually. Just we checked it before, but it's shuffled now. We are knowing now. Nice, sir. By mistake, it may contents. Huh. Abhi sir, block diagram. Huh.
Hello. Good afternoon to all. My name is Sailee Richde. Now I discussed about the block diagram. The in which we connected to that all components. Firstly, I discuss about PVRA. The PVRA, it is mainly consists of PV panels. Which is photovoltaic panels, and then PV panels. It contains PV cells, and the PV cells produce the solar energy, and that solar energy then connected to that solar energy that solar energy is provided to the microcontroller by using charging circuit. The PV cells generally produce 21 volt supply. Then it is supplied to the battery and regulated by using regulator. Regulator provides 12 volt to the microcontroller. Again, there is angle sensor which is used to give the angle to that patient through the screen. Again, there is a driver which is connected to two motors. Now we are using only one motor, and there is again logic converter which is again connected to the laptop. Next. Here is innovative work. Generally, the physiotherapy machines, which are present at physiotherapy centers, they are working on only AC supply. But here we use a solar source, so it is working on the DC source also. Another one is innovative work. Here we here we construct such a machine which is portable, because generally the physiotherapy centers the machines are not portable. So this machine is portable as well as it is cheap, and it can be handled. No, sir, it is not so much costly because at physiotherapy. Yes, sir, it's cheaper. Sorry. In this machine we cannot use so much of complicated circuit here. We only use the transformer and the PCB which is designed, as well as LCD. Next. In the circuit diagram there is again PIC controller, and the motor which is connected by some driver circuit, and there is driver circuit we use two diodes which is working only in forward direction, the diodes are acts as rectifier. Again there is again two regulator circuits, and the main supply which is provided using the AC which is AC supply. Yes, okay, thank you.
Now result. The expected outcomes of this project is to construct innovative light and weight or portable physiotherapy machine for the patients who are unable to walk difficult to take them physiotherapy center for the regular exercise. It is the mobility equipment, so it can improve strength, movement, and it improve coordination too. Also, it is the proposed machine is portable, so we can use anywhere we want. Also, we can use in patient sites also, patient side, to provide solar battery backup for energy conservation. This is the references. Application. It is used in physiotherapy centers. Also, it is used in handicap schools, centers. Again, it can be used in patient sites once setting the details, future scope. There is wide scope of physiotherapy. In future, there is wide scope on physiotherapy. Physiotherapy is an autonomous health profession that is primarily detected to the primarily detected towards the preservation. Physiotherapists get specialized in geriatrics, pediatrics, orthopedics, and etc. It is also in future we also adding more facilities, like we work on other part of our body.
Rupali, batayegi.
Sir, we have submitted the paper in IJDEDR with the registration. Published. Sir, it is published. Sir, submitted actually. Sir, submitted.
Accepted.
Yes. Accepted. Sir, we have got a patent approval for our project with the docket number 51399. Sir, we go.
Sir,
registration. पब्लिश कर दिया ना, पब्लिश कर दिया तो फिर अब सर बोल रहे अब क्या मतलब तुम्हें पेटेंट नहीं मिलेगा. सर प्रोफेसर भावना पारधी मैम. Yes, sir. We published it already. Yes, sir. To the summon. Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Supriya Ambade from Electronics and Telecommunication Department. My project name is Smart Helmet for Coal Mines and Safety Monitoring. My project member name is Veena Ambade, Jyoti Rodge and Pranali Wagmare, under the guidance of Priyanka Chopkar ma'am. Today we are standing here to discuss about the project seminar on Smart Helmet for Coal Mines. This is the content: introduction, literature survey, problem statement, proposed methodology, implementation, work done, innovative work, result and conclusion, reference publications. Introduction. The person who are working in the coal mines has to face various environmental parameters such as a carbon, methane, temperature. These parameters are very dangerous for person who work in the coal mines. In the underground area, it is very dark and noisy, so person can't see each other continuously. So we are adding some work on a helmet. So we need to provide a strong security for person who work in the coal mines. The main purpose of this project to provide a strong security and wireless communication. These are the literature survey. Problem statement. After doing literature survey, it is observed that some work is done for the helmet, but no one can develop, no one system can develop for the roof. So we are adding some work. So we are adding some work on the roof. Sir, paper name Zigbee based helmet for coal mines, IJARS. Isme sir, three sensors lage hue hain. Haan sir. Haan. Sir, ye reference paper mein three sensors lage hain. Temperature sensor, gas sensor and humidity sensors. Wo sab ek hi isme kaam karte hain. Baki sab kisi isme do sensors lage hain, kisi isme teen sensors lage hain. तो सर सेंसर सेम ही है, ह्यूमिडिटी सेंसर, गैस सेंसर एंड टेम्परेचर सेंसर. बाकी कुछ इनोवेशन वर्क नहीं है, इसलिए हमने कुछ इनोवेटिव करने के लिए प्रोजेक्ट में रूफ में ऐड किया है एक्सेलेरोमीटर, माइक्रो एक्सेलेरोमीटर. यस 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 सर. एक्चुअली सेंसर तीन ही है सर, टेम्परेचर, ह्यूमिडिटी एंड गैस सेंसर, लेकिन हमने उसमें इनोवेटिव करने के लिए रूफ फॉलिंग का लिया है. रूफ एक्सेलेरोमीटर. यस सर. Yes, sir, roof falling, environmental parameters such humidity and temperatures. Roof falling means sir, actually accelerometer हमने इसलिए लगा है कि suddenly जो roof falling होता है तो वो detection दिखाने के लिए कि roof falling हो रहा है तो वो. Yes yes sir. Accelerometer sensor.
नेक्स्ट स्लाइड में है सर. हाँ वो proposed methodology. This is our proposed methodology in our project. We are using three types of sensor: gas sensor, humidity sensor, and this is a innovative work in our project. We are using the accelerometer on the roof, on the upper side. Roof will be a collapse. Then the accelerometer will be used to angle as to check the roof position. Accelerometer, roof angle, upper side of roof. Roof, नहीं नहीं, coal mines का जो mine है, उसके अंदर upper side में, जो यहाँ पे रहेगा, यहाँ पे अपन accelerometer, microcontroller and RF transmitter use करेंगे. This upper side, roof. Yes, yes. एक पर्टिकुलर एंगल पे उसको एक्सेलरोमीटर को सेट करेंगे. माइक्रोकंट्रोलर क्या करते हैं? चेंज एंगल चेंज हुआ रूफ का तो हेलमेट का अलग है सर, इसका इसका पोर्शन अलग साइड में रहेगा और डायरेक्ट कनेक्शन रहेगा अलर्ट रूम में.
सर ग्राउंड लेवल पे अलर्ट रूम रहेगी जहाँ पे रिसीवर सेक्शन रहेगा और पर्सन
हेलमेट पे अलग रहेगा और उसका अलग रहेगा. एट नाइन सी फाइव टू
सर एक्चुअली दो ट्रांसमीटर
है एंड
वन
हाँ आर्डिनो बोर्ड रहता है. सॉरी सर वो डिजिटल फॉर्म डिजिटल फॉर्म
सर लेकिन वायरलेस करेंगे तो वो
रेंज नहीं पकड़ेगा ना सर. नीचे से रेंज ही नहीं जाएंगे ऊपर। तो वो माइक्रो कंट्रोल पर जाएगा। अलर्ट रूम पे डाटा ट्रांसमिट करने के लिए सर माइक्रो कंट्रोलर। हाँ 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 वायरलेस था पूरा,
बट सर ने बोले थे पिछली बार कि पॉसिबल नहीं हो सकता है, इसलिए हमने अभी वायर किए हैं।
तो कंस्ट्रक्शन ने बने हैं।
हाँ सर,
एक
मिनट। सर ट्रांसमीटर सेक्शन में दो रहेंगे, इसका एक ब्लॉक डायग्राम रहेगा जो हेलमेट पे है, वहाँ पे थ्री सेंसर सेट रहेगा, और ये रूफ सेक्शन में रहेगा, ये दोनों अंडरग्राउंड एरिया में रहेंगे। फिर वहाँ पे एक रिसीवर रहेगा, तो वो रिसीवर डाटा कलेक्ट करेगा, फिर वो ऊपर में भेजेगा ग्राउंड पर।
डाटा शीट निकालो, उसमें से उसकी लिमिटेशन आपका डेमो है क्या? हाँ, डेमो बताइए आप।
सर, इंडिविजुअल बंदे का कैसे?
अभी कितना बना है?